TV in this preview for the upcoming game on Saturday, the 20th of August, with a 3 p.m. kickoff as the Boro take on Reading in the Scarlet Championship at the Southwark Car Leasing Stadium. But Boro fans were still awaiting our first win of the season as we came this close. I repeat, this close to grabbing our first win of the season, but we ended up drawing 2-2 at Stoke at the Bet365 Stadium in midweek. We did get off to a bit of the worst possible start, you know. We conceded after only just like 19 minutes or so, just under 20 minutes. With Jacob Brown giving Stoke the lead after 19 minutes. I mean, to be honest, it shouldn't really have stood because Isaiah Jones was clearly fouled in the build-up. I mean, I was just looking at the highlights just now. Clearly he got fouled in the build-up, but it's one of those standards of refereeing these days. He needs to be sorted. But we did get our equaliser just before half-time. Great bit of work passing around the Stoke area. Allowed Isaiah Jones to pick in the cross and put it on the plate for Duncan Watmore to grab his first goal of the season to make the 1-1 going into half-time. And then second half, we got a reward with our brilliant possession play with a goal. Duncan Watmore was claiming it, but the last touch did come off Phil Jagielka for an own goal. And we could have won it, you know, we had our chances, but stoppage time again, like it was in the cup against Barnsley. We concede in stoppage time. Cross coming from the right, and you have to put it to the smallest man on the pitch to score. DiMaggio Wright Phillips, obviously living up to his reputation and his pedigree coming from his grandfather Ian Wright and his dad Sean Wright Phillips. But why on earth didn't Dyke still pick him up to begin with? I mean, when I looked at the highlights, both him and Jones could have easily intercepted there. We got in front of Wright Phillips to clear it out, but we didn't. And the header just went past Stephen. Then they'll come away with the point again, and still, like again, still no win in the season. But we go on now. We've got another tough away trip coming up against a team that have just come up one of their big good results so far this season, which I'll explain in a bit. At the Stoke game, we did miss Tuber Akpom through a knee injury, but Chris Wilder said in his press conference that he might return to the squad for the game on Saturday. And also, as of recording, some news in the transfer front, we've apparently agreed a season-long loan move for Fulham striker Rodrigo Nunes. The Brazilian, it was spotted at Rockcliffe earlier on this morning. It was confirmed this morning by Football Insider that he did arrive yesterday at the Riverside for a medical. And we're now just awaiting confirmation from the club whether that deal will go through now. So it doesn't mean he'll play on Saturday, but hopefully by the time in the next game after this, which will be at home against Swansea, he'll be in the squad by then. Apart from that, obviously, there's a couple of names in the squad as well. I mean, yeah, let's say Akpom's still to come back, but apart from that, the rest of the squad's all good to go for now. Now we're going to our opponents, Reading, who obviously are coming off a good result themselves, ending Blackburn's 100% running the league so far with a 3-0 win in our last game at the Select Car Leasing Stadium in midweek. They're currently sitting 8th place going into this game in the Championship. Boro obviously 20th going into this. The record going into this game is played 4, 1-2, drawn 0 and lost 4. Like I said, last game that was beat Blackburn by 3-0. They're under the management of former Boro captain Paul Ince, who's returned to management with them from the start of last season after a couple of years, a few years absent of being away from being a manager. And it's still a good squad, even though considering the situation that Reading find themselves off the pitch since they have the last couple of seasons, it's built a good squad in there at the moment, as Paul is. As the key players to watch out for, obviously, the old phrase goes like father, like son, and obviously Paul Ince does have his son, Thomas Ince, in his ranks at Reading, and obviously he's become a rejuvenated player since he came to Reading. Obviously he had a couple of spells out with a couple of clubs, but hasn't worked out for him, but he's finally rejuvenated himself under his father over at Reading, and Thomas Ince is going to be one player that we do have to watch out for. Junior Hoylett is another player to watch out for as well. Of course, we were linked with him in the past, particularly last season when we were under Warnock. And he was a nightmare